Hi guys, my name is Jameel Ahmad, and you know that we were discussing about the general principles of pharmacology, second chapter about pharmacodynamics, and we were discussing about the graded quantitative dose response curves. In previous two lectures, we discussed about the parallel and non-parallel dose responsive curves, and second lecture, we discussed about the partial and full agonistic curves, and also we see the duality of the partial agonist curves. Now in this lecture, we will see about the antagonism and potentiation curves. That what is this? So, graded quantitative dose response curves, we will see the antagonism and potentiation. First, you must know that what is the antagonism and what is the potentiation. So, first, antagonist. So, you know that to understand the antagonist, you must know the agonist, which we have also explained in the previous lecture. So, now this is the agonist. Let's suppose that this is the agonist. Agonist is a drug. This is a drug which acts on the receptors, which goes and acts on the receptors of the target cells and shows some response and shows its actions. That is called the agonist drug. But what is the antagonist drug? Now we will see the antagonist drug. This is the drug which goes and binds with the receptors of the target cells and block the receptors, and it prevents the response. So it will not give the response. What is the antagonist? This is a drug which will go bind with the receptors and prevent the receptors to bind with the agonist, and it will prevent the response. Simply you can say that when agonist will go and will bind with the receptors, then it will give some response. But when antagonist will go and it will bind with the receptors, it will not give any response. So it will stop the response and it will give the response. Simply you must know that. So it is about antagonism. Understand. In detail, we will explain in this talk. What is the potentiation? The potentiation is it's about potency. You know that potency we have explained in the previous lecture. Potency is the concentration. This is the concentration of drug. This is the concentration of drug for desired effect. That is called the potency. Okay, concentration of a drug for desired effect, for desired action, that is called the potency. It is about potentiation. So please come here in this graph and explain this antagonism and potentiation in detail. So in this graph you see that we are taking response on y-axis and log dose of a drug on x-axis. But in this graph you must know that this one, middle one, the green one line, green one curve, this is our control curve. This graph is about agonist. You know that this log dose of a drug basically is the dose of agonist drug. Okay, this is the agonist drug, and this is the control curve, or we can say that this is the response of a agonist drug. Okay, agonist drug. So we take some agonist drug on x-axis and shows response on y-axis. So it is control curve, and it's about agonist curve. Okay, so now we will compare this agonist drug, the response of this agonist drug, by adding some competitive antagonists and non-competitive antagonists. So the concepts comes here, the competitive antagonist and non-competitive antagonist. To understand this concept, you must know that what is the competitive and non-competitive antagonist. So please come here first, that what is the competitive antagonist and what is the non-competitive antagonist. The competitive antagonist. In competitive antagonist, as the name indicates, that there is a competition between agonist and antagonist to bind to the receptors. So both have the same receptor. Both have the same receptors. Let's suppose that come here, that this is a target cell. This is a target cell and it has a receptor. So we have two drugs, drug 1, drug 2. Drug 1 acts as an agonist. This is the agonist. And drug 2 is acts as the antagonist. So both will come and will bind with the same receptor, but with a competition. With a competition, agonist will would like to bind with this same receptor, and antagonist would also like to bind with the same receptor. So both have a competition, and they have a weak ionic bond with the receptor. Agonist drug will form weak ionic bond with the receptor, and antagonist drug will also form the weak ionic bond with the receptors. And in this concept, he says that increasing the concentration, we can change the state. What is this? That, as you know, that there is a competition between both of these drugs. So if we are going to increase the concentration of agonist, so agonist is more in concentration. So agonist will go and bind with the receptors in a better way. So agonist will win, drug 1 will win, and it will bind with the receptor. So in this way, state will change. Now, if we increase the concentration of antagonist, that is the drug 2, then it will go and it will bind with the receptors in a better way, because now its concentration is more as compared to drug 1. So it will bind with the receptors in a better way. So this one will win and state will be changed in this way. So we can change the state by changing the concentration. Next is about non-competitive antagonist. Non-competitive antagonist is also just like a same receptor. These are also the same receptors. But what is the concept in this? That there is a no competition. There is that antagonist will come and it will bind to the receptors by covalent bond. That is a strong permanent bond. It will not break at all. So antagonist will come and it will bind to the receptors by strong permanent covalent bond, and it will be irreversible. So in this case, there is a no competition. Let's suppose that same receptor, that is the R on a target cell, and we have two drugs. Drug 1 is a agonist and drug 2 is an antagonist. So as you know, that antagonist drugs comes and bind with the receptors and prevent the response. So this antagonist will come and it will bind with the receptors by covalent bond. So it is a very strong bond. So first, this antagonist will come and it will form the covalent bond with the receptor. So, receptor is not free. No receptor is free. All receptors are being occupied by the drug 2, that is the antagonist. So, drug 1 will come and it would like to form the bond with the receptors. But receptors are not free. So, drug 1 will not form the bond with the receptors. When there is a no bond of an antagonist, no bond of agonist, then there will be no response, because there is a no agonist is going to bind with the receptors. When agonist will not bind with the receptor, then there will be no response. But there is an antagonist that is bound to the receptor and there is a no response. So there will be the no response. So we can say that by changing the concentration, there is a no change in the state. Why? Because there is a covalent bond. There is a covalent and permanent bond. So now we are going to increase the concentration. We are going to increase the concentration of drug 1, that is the agonist. So when we increase the concentration of agonist, we see that there is a no change. Why? Because the bond is covalent bond. That is a permanent, irreversible bond. This bond will not break at all. Either we are increasing the how much amount of the drug 1, that is the agonist. So there will be no change in the state. So it was little bit about competitive agonist and competitive antagonist and non-competitive antagonist. So I think now you are able to understand the concept of competitive antagonist and non-competitive antagonist. We have also explained these terms: competitive antagonist, non-competitive antagonist, potency, efficacy, affinity, antagonist, agonist, in our separate lecture, whose link is given below in this lecture. So now please come back to your lecture, and now this is okay. Now we will move towards the graph again. So let's suppose that this graph is of agonist. The control curve is for agonist. So we take the agonist on the x-axis and we get the response on the y-axis. So we take the log dose of a drug, which drug? Agonist drug, on the x-axis and get the response on the y-axis, and this is our first curve we got. After giving the agonist dose. So let's suppose that we give the dose of agonist drug, and it gives us the response. I think it's about 100%. So it's about 100% response. So it is giving 100% response. This is simple our agonist drug. Now we are going to compare this agonist drug with competitive and non-competitive antagonists. As you see that we are going to compare the antagonism. So now we are going to add the competitive antagonistic drug. When we will add the competitive antagonistic drug, then it will cause the parallel shift to the right in the dose response curves of our agonist. Mean that this curve will shift towards the right. So this curve will shift towards the right. So now it has been shifted towards the right. But second thing is that is the parallel shift. Mean that is same like that of this one. As you can see that agonist curve and antagonist competitive curve just like same. So this shift is towards the right, and this curve is also the same. Both are the same. But here arises the question, why this curve is just parallel, why this curve is just the same, and why this curve moved towards the right? Why this curve moved towards the right? Two questions. Why move towards the right, and why this curve is parallel, same? Simple question, simple answer. As you can see that, this is the competitive antagonist. So weak anionic bond, and by increasing the concentration, we can change the state. So please come here. So now, here was the agonist, we add the antagonist and it moves towards the right and same. So by changing the concentration, we can change the state. So we are going to increase the agonist. Okay, so we are going to increase the agonist, and there is a no covalent bond, there is an ionic bond. Okay, so now we are going to increase the agonist. As the agonist will increase, there is a competition. There is a competition between drug 1 and drug 2. When agonist will increase, then agonist will go and it will bind with the receptors, and this one will win and this bond will break. So this one will win. But now we have increased the dose. We have increased the dose. We have increased the concentration. So we will come here. Okay. There is a competition between drug 1 and drug 2. Then we will increase the drug 1 competition. It will go and it will bind with the receptors and which show the action. But now we have increased the dose. And we have come here. We have increased the dose. But response is same. 100%. Because by increasing the concentration, we will get the response. Again, I'm going to repeat that. Drug 2 has bond with receptors. But now we will increase the concentration of drug 1. And it will bind with the... then this bond will break. And this bond will form. And this agonist will show the response. That is 100%. But in this case, we have increased the dose. So we will come here. Therefore, this will move towards the right. But you can see that still the response is 100%. Therefore, it has the same identical curve. Okay. Can be reversed by increasing dose of agonist drug. That is about that we have increased the dose and we have reversed the mechanism. That first in the antagonism, no response, and if we increase the concentration, we can change the state as well. Third is about appear to decrease potency of the drug. As you can see there, by increasing the dose, it will move towards the right. Antagonism will move towards the right. And you know that. What is the, how we can compare the potency of our drug? Remember in previous lectures that potency, we can compare the potency. Let's suppose that this is a potency. What is the potency? Potency is the concentration of a drug to a desired effect. But as you know that, the curve closer to y-axis has greater potency. So this one has the closer to the y-axis, so it has the greater potency, but this one is away from the y-axis, so it has the less potency. So potency will decrease. Basically, what is the potency? This is the concentration of a drug for desired effect. If this effect is same, that is about 50%. Let's suppose that this desired effect is same, that is about the 50%. Then we will check the concentration of our drug. If less concentration is showing the 50% response, then potency will be greater. And same, and the drug has more concentration and it is showing the 50% response, then it has less potency. So mean that less concentration, desired effect is constant, but then less concentration drug will have the high potency, and greater concentration drug will have the low potency. As you can see that here is a this effect is constant, same, but here is a concentration change. This one has the low concentration, okay, so it has the greater potency, and this one has the high concentration, so this one has the lesser potency, okay, but response is same. So it was about that. Now we will move towards the non-competitive antagonist drug. The non-competitive antagonist drugs, this one is the curve for that. This is quite different from that one. That one was the shift towards the right but parallel, and this one is the non-parallel shift towards the right. It is not moving too much towards the right, but it is moving towards the down. So it is moving down. It is not moving towards the right. It is moving too much down. Why? As you can see that there is a irreversibly antagonist. Mean that bind to receptors permanently. Antagonist will go and it will bind with the receptors permanently. So this will go and bind with the receptors by covalent bond. Permanent bond. Okay. So this will go and bind with the receptors by the covalent bond. So in this way, the curve will not move towards the right. Why? The curve will move towards the right, but less amount. But why this curve has been decreased low? Okay, the question is this, that why this curve will decrease low? So no, first we are going to increase the concentration of drug one. So we increase the concentration, curve will move towards the right because concentration has been increased. Okay, the second thing, that why this moved down? As you can see, that by increasing the concentration, can we change the state? No, we can't change the state. No, there will be the no bond of drug one. There is the no bond of agonist with the receptors. When no bond of receptor, then there will be the no response. There will be the no efficacy. Mean the response will decrease. Response will decrease. And you know that when response will decrease, then this curve will decrease. Okay? And response will decrease, then this curve will decrease. And response decrease means that efficacy of a drug decrease. Efficacy of a drug will increase, decrease, so it will appear to be decreased efficacy of a agonist. So, okay, I am going to repeat non-competitive, that is the different from the competitive, that in non-competitive, curve will move towards the right a little bit because we are going to increase the concentration. We are going to increase the concentration to change the state. We have increased the concentration, so curve will move towards the right. But it is not similar to that one. That is quite similar. It is different. It has moved towards down. Why? Because you know that there is a covalent bond, permanent irreversible covalent bond, permanent irreversible covalent bond. When there is a permanent irreversible covalent bond, then by increasing the concentration, there will be the no same response. Response will decrease because no bond formation, no response. So response will decrease. So response will decrease mean that effectiveness of a drug will decrease. Drug will become less effective and its efficacy will decrease. So its efficacy will decrease. So it was a little bit comparison of an agonist with the competitive and non-competitive. Now we will move towards the examples. Okay. In examples, if you talk about the examples, then most drugs are the competitive antagonists. So if there is a case and you know that there is a drug that is the antagonist, then you must say that this is the competitive antagonist, because most drugs are the competitive antagonists, but some few drugs are the non-competitive antagonists. I am going to give the list of that drugs, that is the few drugs: phenoxybenzamine, digoxin, allopurinol, and proton pump inhibitors and aspirin. These some drugs act as a non-competitive antagonist, as most drugs act as a competitive antagonistics. So now we will talk about these. Phenoxybenzamine, digoxin, allopurinol, proton pump inhibitors and aspirin are some non-competitive inhibitors. And as you know that, what is the function of phenoxybenzamine? Remember that? The function of phenoxybenzamine, that it is the blocker of alpha 1 and alpha 2 receptors. So this is the phenoxybenzamine, is the alpha 1 alpha 2 blocker. So phenoxybenzamine, alpha 1 alpha 2 blocker drug, antagonist. And this is the non-competitive, remember that word. And next is the digoxin. Digoxin is the drug, remember that this drug is used for the antiarrhythmia. Control the heartbeat. This is used for the to control the heartbeat, and it blocks the sodium and potassium ATPase. So digoxin, which is used as an antiarrhythmic drug, this is a non-competitive drug which is used to inhibit the sodium and potassium ATPase pump. Okay, and next is the allopurinol. This is also a drug which is used to inhibit the xanthine oxidase. This is a drug which is used to inhibit, so used to block the xanthine oxidase enzyme. But this drug is the non-competitive antagonist. And next is the proton pump inhibitors. And you know that proton pump inhibitors, this is also a non-competitive antagonist which blocks or inhibits the potassium and sodium ATPase in our stomach, like omeprazole. You can think of omeprazole example drug. Omeprazole drug, this is a proton pump inhibitor drug. It blocks the sodium and potassium ATPase. It inhibits the sodium and potassium ATPase in our stomach to control the acidity of our stomach. And this is the non-competitive antagonist. Okay. Next is the aspirin. Remember that aspirin is used to inhibit the which enzyme? That is the cyclooxygenase. oxygenase. So this is the aspirin is also the non-competitive antagonistic drug that inhibits the cyclooxygenase enzyme. So remember these five drugs used as the non-competitive antagonistic drugs, but most drugs act as a competitive antagonistic drug. So it was about the one part of the graph. Now there is a second part that is about the potentiation. So in potentiation, you will see that cause a parallel shift to left dose response curves. Mean that in this case, this curve will move towards the left. But this is the same again, parallel curve. So you can see that this is the opposite to antagonism. In antagonism, it was moving towards the right. But in this potentiation, it is moving towards the left. So please come and discuss this point. In this point, I would like to give one example that is about the benzodiazepine and GABA. So let's take the example of benzodiazepine plus GABA. And as you know that, what is the function of GABA? The function of GABA that GABA is used to open the chloride channels. Okay. And what is the function of benzodiazepine? Benzodiazepine, this is a drug which helps the GABA, which acts on the GABA A receptors. It acts on the GABA alpha receptors and helps in opening the chloride channel. So what is the function of GABA? GABA is itself an agonist. It is itself an agonist. It will go, it's itself an agonist drug. It will go and will cause the open up chloride channels. And benzodiazepine function is also that. It is also acts as an agonist. It will go and acts on the, it is also agonist. It will go and acts on the GABA A receptors. And it will also help the opening the chloride channel. So it will help the GABA. So in this graph, let's suppose that this again comes towards the control curve. Now we are going to discuss potentiation. That take this one curve, that is the control curve, that is the agonist curve. And in this agonist curve, we are taking the example of GABA. Okay. So we take the so much amount of GABA and it gives the response, 100% response, and it is causing the opening of chloride channels. Okay. So now we add the benzodiazepine. We add the benzodiazepine, and you know that by adding the benzodiazepine will act on the GABA A receptors and cause it will help to open the chloride channel. So now it is helping the GABA. So now it is helping the GABA for giving the response. So therefore, this curve will move towards the right because now potency will increase. Potency will increase because now we need less amount of GABA to show the action because now there is also benzodiazepine which is helping this one. So in this way, this curve will move towards the left because now there is no need to increase the concentration of drug. Rather, we need to decrease the concentration of drug. So concentration will decrease. GABA was showing its action. So GABA acts as an agonist and it was acting and it was showing its response by opening the chloride. Now we add the benzodiazepine and benzodiazepine will go by acting on the GABA alpha receptors. It will also help the GABA to open the chloride channels. So it means that potency will increase. So now we need small amount of GABA to show the response. Therefore, concentration will decrease, but response is same. So as the concentration will decrease, response is same, so potency will increase. But the concept you have to remember, this is that that in potentiation, cause a parallel shift to right, okay, and in this case, potency of a agonist will increase. Potency will increase, therefore it will move towards the right. As you can see that, the curve closer to the y-axis, that has the greater potency, so it will move towards the y-axis. So it has moved towards the y-axis, therefore its potency will increase. So it was a little bit about the antagonism and potentiation. But in a quick review, you must remember the main concept that I am going to tell you that. The main concept are that in competitive antagonistics, that the curve will move towards the right, but in a parallel way. And in non-competitive, the curve will move towards the right, but in non-parallel way. Okay, in this parallel way, in this non-parallel way. As you can see that this is a parallel way, and this is non-parallel way, downward more. And the second part that can be reversed by increasing dose of the agonist drug, and in this way, can be only partially reversed, with a small amount can be reversed. and it is appears to be decreased potency. That's very important in this case. Potency will decrease, and in this point, efficacy will decrease. As you can see that it is moving away from the incompletive. It is moving away from the y-axis, meaning that its potency in decreases because it is moving away from the y-axis. And you can see that here is a decreasing height. When height is decreasing, means that efficacy is decreasing. And next is the examples that most drugs act as a competitive antagonist and small drugs act as a non-competitive antagonist. And that drugs are these few drugs: phenoxybenzamine, digoxin, allopurinol, proton pump inhibitors, and aspirin. Okay. And the next thing is about potentiation and potentiation causes a parallel shift to left. So it will cause the parallel shift to left. It is opposite to antagonism. And it is again parallel, identical to this one, and will move towards the left. And this concept and this thing you have to learn that in this case it increases the potency of our antagonist. It increases the potency of the antagonist. In this case, potency will increase. So it was about the graded quantitative dose response curves, which is about antagonism and potentiations. So thank you so much, guys.